week ago, nearly one in four eligible South Carolina voters found their way to a voting booth. And usually election officials would expect a smaller number in next week's runoff. But as News 4's Gordon Dill reports, this year may be different. In fact, turnout may go up.
Believe it or not, this is not file video of a primary election. This is the line of voters steady all day at Greenville County Square for absentee voting in the runoff election.
We feel pretty strongly about several of the candidates, so we want to be sure and vote.
If enough people have strong feelings, this could be a very unusual election, because while primary turnout exceeded official expectations, this runoff may attract more new voters motivated by last-minute campaigns.
The campaigns are saying, you know, look at all these people we need to try to motivate to turn out in the runoff that didn't turn out in the first one. You know, I mean, you could literally take those that didn't turn out and win this election.
In fact, despite primary turnout above 20%, there are still hundreds of thousands of eligible voters who may not have taken signs until now. And the runoff rules are relatively simple. Almost all registered voters can vote, unless they voted in a different party's primary. That is, if you voted in the Democratic primary, you can't vote in the Republican runoff and vice versa. That's it. Judging by the already high turnout for absentee voting, it is possible this could be that very rare circumstance where turnout goes up for a runoff.
The thing about voters is that we can never quite figure them out. Sometimes they vote early, sometimes they vote late, and sometimes they don't vote at all.
The line is already forming. Thousands of votes are already cast. Gordon Dill, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
And the runoff election is next Tuesday, the 22nd. Absentee voting is already underway. To read more about the candidates, you can look for the Commitment 2010 section of our website, WYFF4.com.